Ragazzi, ragazzi, voglio il silenzio. Okay, I've just been talking to our idiot chairman about our goals for the season. I was obviously talking about our other idiot chairman, Thomas. Enough! We're here to discuss our targets for 2018. Now, as I said, I've had a meeting with our other idiot chairman, and we have agreed upon fourth as a target. That is our official target. Gazzetta dei Motori comes knocking. You tell them that we will be proud, happy, and thrilled to come fourth. UKSN rocks up with a camera crew. You sing a happy little We Love Fourth song. It is not, however, our real target. Max, kill the lights, please. On the screen, you can see how Max and I would like this season to play out. 10th, we want to see Archer BMR. I want them so far in 10th that they finish the season in a concrete apartment block in the inner suburbs of hell without air conditioning. And in Alex Rogers' case, I want him to have big panoramic windows which catch the afternoon sun and don't have any curtains. In 9th place, and this one is naturally from Max Vexala. Nice little cottage in the outer suburbs of hell with no trees for 5 kilometres in any direction will be fine for them. 8th through to 3rd, I could not care less about, and I have no interest in which teams occupy those positions. 2nd, I am happy for Ozu to have. You might remember Ozu, they are the ones who have been relegated from the Asia-Pacific Super Cup into our competition, and that was because they were kind enough to be sufficiently incompetent that they were able to lose to our largely useless Italian brothers in the APS, specifically Zampelli and Locatelli. That, let me tell you, is no mean feat. But the fact that they were so incompetent means that they got relegated instead of the Italian teams, and therefore we owe them for this service to Italian racing. Now, of course, as soon as we arrive in APS, we will need to set about destroying Zampelli and Lucatelli ourselves, but Italian politics has been that way for over 2,000 years, so it would be optimistic to believe that things will change now. Yes, I know, that is still so depressing I can't even speak about it. Now this, of course, means that our real target for the year is... Anyone have any opinions? Ragazzi, basta! Just listen to the plan. Fede, let's start with you. Welcome back, or welcome for the first time, to TM1 Bytes Weekend Edition Episode 26, where we return to the saga of Scuderia Quantistica, finally! But there will be no racing this weekend because we have other things to do. We are in the interseason between 2017 and 2018, and that means that we have to, first off, build a chassis, second, test the chassis, third, set our targets for the coming year, and fourth, hope to heaven... That's the legend, Mr. Why is that on save? The legend, Mr. Gary Watson, actually gets through all of those. Oh, that's right. We've still got the repairs. Why do they do repairs after race 10 when there's nothing left to do on the car? We have to hope that Gary will get the parts that are our carryover parts up to their maximum before we go over. But we'll have to take a look at that later because we can't get to the car at the moment. In the mailbox, let's start with that this week. Fox, we don't care about that, that's practice. Car condition update, 12 hours, go for it, Gary. Just, actually, don't. Just dump the chassis into a ditch somewhere. We're not going to use them again. Interviews with World Sports Network. Okay, accept interview. Andre Gomes was beaten by Molly Fox today. Would you consider bringing her in next season? Of course she's... Gomes was beaten by Molly Fox. We've still got... cruddy engines, we've still got no We have a lot of work to do. Perhaps was no. I'm not going to say that. I'm not going to disrespect Gomes that way. Gomes lost because, well, Gomes got lost in part because he's a mediocre driver. Yes, I'll give you that. But mostly it's because his car was not competitive. That would be a hang on. No way. I have 100% belief in our drivers. Now the problem there is that that means that Molly Fox is going to go, oh well, I'm not going to talk to you for a year, and I might want to talk to Molly Fox. I don't know. I don't know if I've scouted her yet. Perhaps, but it's a little early to be talking about the silly season. In case you missed the headline there, we're not going to be doing any staff changes for 2018 because it's too late in the year to be doing that. Sylvia didn't find me any drivers that really excited me to any great degree. And Gomes and Thomas are both signed on for 2 years anyway. So nobody's contract is expiring at the end of this year. So I don't plan to make any changes. Perhaps, but it's a little early to be talking about. No, I don't want to say that because that's going to, that's probably going to drop Gomez's morale, and he doesn't deserve that. If Fox is interested, that would be a marvellous idea. She would then talk to us, but it'd probably dump Gomez's. I don't like any of these answers, and I wouldn't give any of these answers in real life, but I'm going to give that one simply because, yeah, I don't think Molly, I like Molly, I think she's a good driver, but I pretty sure we would have scouted her by now, and she obviously didn't float my boat, or I would have been thinking, yeah, got to get Molly. Oh yeah, she's not going to talk to us. Won't even discuss terms with you. I don't actually mind that. So if we take a look at Molly, finish interview. She's only got 43, and part of that is reigning ERS champion. That's 20, so her marketability is not particularly good anyway. Her driving stats are rather nice, and she's still got a full star to fill out. She's rather expensive. She's more expensive than Falco, and I couldn't afford Falco, and Falco has better marketability. So, no, not really interested anyway. But, sorry, Molly. Didn't mean to offend you. Right. Four pit stops. Fastest time was 10.213. That's irrelevant. The fastest pit stop time doesn't matter because it depends on what you're doing in the pit stops. Mistake-free weekend, thank the gods for that. Now, it's going to be interesting to see what happens with the pit crew. At the start of this year, they reset to full stamina, and I don't know whether that was because the pit crew only came in for me in the competition that I was recording partway through 2016, and then it started 2017 as if it was a new thing, or whether it happens every year. So it'll be interesting to see what happens with that. I think it does actually reset every year. Hard-fought win in the Black Sea for Fox. Yeah, Stone Jr. finished second for Garuda. And Thomas rounding out the podium. You can say a little more about Sarah. I wouldn't mind. All right, let's take a look at this. So it looks like, well, if they're going to reset, they haven't reset yet. We've got three in the higher area. What have we got there? Capuzzo, 13,085, 0.1. Four on the tyres, forget about it. 11, 12, ooh, except for 70 out of 70. No, and 0.7%. No, for €12,000. What do you think I am, crazy? Reject, reject, reject. Sylvia, I know you need a level 2 scouting centre, but please try to get me something better. That's it. Let's move on. Okay, car repair is complete. I want to take a look at that. Improved parts. All right, so, Gary, what have you got to do, my man? You show us 15 days after the race, so you've got about 2 weeks to get those up to the appropriate level. All right, I just jotted down the scores there so that I can keep an eye on that. We've just got to hope for the best on that one. That mail is probably just the advice from Gary that everything is complete. Let me just take a look at the calendar and see if I can work out exactly when things are going to happen. So we've got scouting, pre-season start. We've got until the 12th. He's not going to make it. I think that is the drop-dead date when we can no longer be doing doing part upgrades. So he'll come close. He'll come close. We're just going to be a little more careful about budgeting our time next year. It would be a lot easier if Federico had a level 2 design center so that he'd get the parts up a little bit faster, but there's nothing we can do about that. Anyway, let's continue on. Right, we have several pieces of mail. Prize money for the 2017 series. We'll come back to that. Vittorio Corsa's chairman to retire. Arianna Bruno. The entire team has a lot to thank Arianna Bruno for, said his replacement? I don't think Arianna is a male name. And more to the point, I've seen Arianna before, and I'm pretty sure she was a female. Eugenia Rudler, really. 59-year-old has been in charge of the Italy-based team for years now, so it'll be interesting to see how the new boss adapts. Right. Okay, driver of the season. Who is the driver of the season? Oh, Sarah Thomas of Scuderia Quantistica. I don't know how she got that. I mean, compared to... I think these driver of the season, manager of the season things are based on how far ahead you end up of where you started out or where you were expected to be. So Sarah did make a pretty good charge at the end of the year, so that could be why it is. Manager of the season, who is that? Second year running, baby! Second year running! Ah, okay. Ho vinto! Right, Ernie Heckelrock, prize money for 2017. Now, this is where the interesting bit comes in. So we are now on the 5th of December. And this is important. Prize money for the 2017 series. Do try not to spend it all at once. I shall certainly spend some of it at once, Ernie, because you and I know exactly what I'm going to do with some of that money. Receive the prize money. How much are we getting? 12.5 million euros. That will be very nice indeed. I haven't actually done a budget for next year because obviously I don't know how much the chassis is going to cost and I don't know how much I'm going to get from Thomas yet. So, 12.5 million. It is the 5th of December. What do we do with that 12.5 million? We go and spend some of it. New buildings. Test track. 8 million euros. Oh, the pain. But we are going to get great engines, and that is going to cost us 24 weeks. 24 weeks. Let me note that down. 8 million. Build that sucker. Okay, test track is under construction. Alright, I make the completion date of that 22 May 2018. Possibly I should have sent us into the red a little bit and tried to get that a bit earlier, but we don't know what the calendar is for next year yet, so we shall just have to see. Actually, there might still be a way of seeing that, because this is the 2017 calendar and the dates should be roughly similar. So if it's 22 May, means that it's going to come in between races 3 and 4, between Milan and Tondela. There is no way in heck that I don't think Federico will actually get up to making the good engines at that point anyway, but we'll just have to see how that plays out. It does mean that we should be able to get some great engines into Dens, Munich, Guildford, so most of the season. Hopefully that will be okay. What's coming up? Absolutely nothing of any particular interest. Let's go. And as soon as I clicked on that, we got two pieces of mail. What have we got now? 2018 rules active. Groove tyres. Okay, so hopefully that will reduce our costs a little bit. Promotions and relegations. Well, we know who's going up and who's going down. Velan have been promoted. Velan have gone back into WMC. I mean, I knew that Velan had come first. That was what I'd been talking about for the last few episodes. But to be perfectly honest, I'm really surprised that they have elected to take promotion, because their problem was that they got relegated the season before that in 2016, and I would have thought that they'd want to do a little bit more spade work in the APS to get themselves in a better state to go back into WMC. But anyway, Asia Pacific Super Cup, Garuda have been promoted. I expected that to happen, where Ozu will drop down to take their place. Ozu having lost to Lucatelli and Zampelli, so it's the Japanese team that's coming down to join us next year. I've already scouted their drivers. They're not anything that particularly scares me at the moment. Let's continue on. We've been getting lots of swooshes. What was that about? Sponsor deals. We had sponsor deals to take care of. Okay, Sylvia. Sylvia, what have you got for me? Koto Mazzalella would be one of the stronger drivers. Doesn't have a huge amount of potential. Who's he with? Zampelli. Right, I'd been scouting him because that was one of the teams that I thought might be coming down. Iceman, marketability minus 50, which means that he's got a marketability of 0. Yes, no, that's definitely not what we want. And he's too expensive for a reserve driver, he's not a pay driver, so he's got some good stats. Braking is not so great. But yes, let's not concern ourselves with him. Sponsors, how many have we got? We've got 3 offers available in slot 3. We've got 1 offer available in slot 1. I'm not going to worry about that for the moment. I want to get all 3 offers in so we can look at both at the same time. Let's go. Now we get to the meat of this episode. Must respond. Just give us the word and we'll get started. Design New Year's car. We release the $7 million that we had put aside during the year. Notwithstanding, it's going to cost us about $9 million, so let's get on it. All right, so what have we got? Again, I'm more concerned about the base stat modifier. Doesn't worry me very much, mainly because Freddy has incredibly good stats in engines, and also because we are going to have a test track this year, so we are going to be getting stats anywhere we need them, basically. So my focus is on improvability, just as it was last year. Only this time, we want to make sure that we actually get our parts up to the maximum improvability that we can do. So, Shimizu, very weak, very weak. No way in heck. Both of these are 3.8 million. Now, the improvability in both is medium, plus 2 base stat modifiers, so they're exactly the same between those ones. The only difference is fuel efficiency, where the Merceau is weak, whereas the Rossini is very weak. So, yeah, sure, I'd prefer an Italian engine over a French one, but come on, I mean, I'm not getting anything. I'm paying exactly the same money, and I'd be getting worse fuel efficiency, so it's pretty much a no-brainer on that one. Remember, too, I don't know whether I made this point when we went through this last year, when we were going back into tutorial mode for a bit, the offers that you get for suppliers will vary. If you were to replay this particular section from the last game save, you would actually get different offers. So I'm going to go with the Merceau. So that gives us 1 star of fuel efficiency. It gives us a little over 1 star of improvability. Fuel supplier will be, and the improvability stars, remember, there's a certain number of points that you will be able to add to them to max value depending on your improvability. All right, so again, we have improvability here. Very weak, weak, very weak. So obviously that is the one that we prefer to go for. The only downside to that, of course, is that that has medium fuel efficiency and that has weak fuel efficiency. But nonetheless, we're going to be doing relatively well this year because we will have more parts development capability than most of the other teams, and I would say any of the other teams, but we are still behind. We're still coming from a position which is so far behind, it's not funny. So I am going to again emphasize the improvability and go for 1.5 million. So it gets us weak improvability, which is better than the other two, even at the cost of fuel efficiency. So the fuel efficiency now goes to 1.25 stars. The material supplier, which is going to affect our tire heating and tire wear, very weak, very weak. No, I'm not going to do that just to save money. Weak, weak, medium, and very. Oh, great. So you've got the trade-off there. It's not just a question of money. If you go for Carbulon, you'll get better tire wear, but you'll also get worse tire heating. And if you get bad tire heating, that's going to affect your tire wear anyway. So I think I shall go for the compromise candidate here, which will actually save me $1.5 million anyway. Yes, I would like to have better tire wear, but I don't know that I want it at the expense of tire heating, given the fact that, as I said, tire heating is going to drive your tire wear anyway. So let's go with the straight down the line option. Brake supplier. We're already up to 8.8 million. We had 7 million in the kitty. So naturally, as it happens every year, we have to dig into our savings to make up the difference. We haven't selected our brake supply yet. Very weak, discount that. There's no way I'm going to go for that. Very weak and weak, weak and medium. So, tyre wear, tyre heating. All right, I'm prepared to pay the extra $2 million to get better tyre heating and better tyre wear, because, as you can see, we're obviously still down in the lower categories of tyre wear and tyre heating, and I don't want to be in the back of the field for that one. So let's just take a look at last year's supply. We went for Merceau, Oceana, Morimoto materials, and JP Racetech. It looks like we have built exactly the same chassis. So that possibly should worry me, except for the, because obviously our chassis was not great last year, but I really do think that's the best we can do. The only thing that we could do that might be slightly better, well, there's nothing we can do there for the fuel supplier. No, because we've got that trade-off again between, I suppose we could go for medium fuel efficiency and very weak improvability, but no, I think our part development is where we've got our strength this year and we need to play to it. So that's it. That's going to cost us 12.3 million. We'll only have about 4 million left in the kitty. Let's do it. I'll get a bit of a discount on that. So, not as much as I'd like. Confirm. Okay. Now it's down to Federico. Let's continue on. Improvability gains. Wow, 11 males. Okay, what have we got here? Movement around the track. Strambi joins Ozu. Nicola Strambi. Okay, replacing Ebony Tyler. Okay, I don't think I've scouted him, so we're going to have to do that. Actually, let's go do that now. No, I have scouted him. I don't know who he was with previously. No, he was with Ozu previously. He may have been their backup driver previously. That's the only thing I can think. Kruger have picked up Ebony Tyler. Okay, so who's she replacing? Who is she replacing? Hang on. Kruger. Isn't that where Falco was? Where the hell's Falco? Okay, we don't have time to look at that at the moment. I'm conscious of episode length. Vexala pick up Diosti. Okay, so Diosti's wages are rumored to be blah, 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 blah. Who is here? These pieces of information are very interesting, but I want to know who they're replacing. Octane signed. Octane have signed Faith? Holy crud, they've replaced Claudia with Faith? They have lost their Canadian mind. Somebody must have put something in their maple syrup. They have replaced Claudia with Faith. Well, this is a turn up for the books. I think possibly Faith is going to be, shall we say, a little bit hacked off when she gets out on the racetrack, especially if she is anywhere near Sarah Thomas. Oh my God, the world has gone mad. Dreyfus has gone to join Dragon. Now, I will admit, this is a good thing for Dragon, but I cannot see how it's a good thing for Claudia. So I don't know whether Claudia walked out on Octane and Octane just picked up Faith because they couldn't afford anything better. No disrespect to Faith, but come on, you know how old she is. But she still does have that racer characteristic, so that's going to be interesting. Yeah, I have no idea. All right, scouting finished. Ebony Tyler. Okay, she's gone to Kruger now, and she was previously with Ozu. All right. We'll deal with that issue as it comes around to us on the track. Alex Willis would be an average driver. He's in Lucatelli. Okay, so he's not bad stats. Old. 35. Yes. Oh, my hip. Yeah. It's terribly, terribly ages series, this one. Oh, my God, there's more. Contri is Strambi's new race mechanic at Ozu Motor Team. Okay, David Contry, I don't know him. Let's find out about him. Okay, nothing special. Not compared to Gary, anyway. Improvability gains. We've been looking at the placement of the new fuel tank. Looks like there's some flexibility there. Ah, this is one of the ones where we swap one thing for another. Some small adjustments would give us large gains in the car's overall improvability. Now, if this was last year, I'd have seriously considered going for that. But... See, this is one of the things that I really like about this game. It evolves over time as well. There was a time when I would have said, sell the farm to get improvability. But the thing is that this year, if we want to achieve fourth, and you know, our target is fourth. Yes, our target will be fourth, I'm sure of this. Then we are going to need fuel efficiency as well. And we have a heck of a lot of improvability between Freddy's skills and the headquarters facilities that we are going to have. We are going to be able to make pretty big gains in our base numbers, which will probably more than compensate for an extra 6 points of improvability. And the fuel efficiency is probably going to cost us on the racetrack. I think I'm going to pass this one by. Yeah, because I think we'll get enough improvability as it is, and I don't want to sacrifice our fuel efficiency, which is already rubbish. So let's leave it. All right, we've got six sponsors. Let's take a look at that. Okay, sponsors, what do we got here? I said, what do we got here? All right, slot one, race bonus sponsors. We're going to have to think really, really carefully about this. What's our marketability at the moment? 79 point, okay. Now, Sarah's still got a boost. Andre doesn't. That's his base marketability. We're just shy of 80%. I'd be happier over 80%. Let's see what we've got. So that's our back market position. Let's take a look at what the other one is. So hang on, what's that one? Third or above, so that must be the mid-ranking position. Slot 3 would be the top-ranking position, first, second, or first. 6 races, 4 races, 5 races. Now, the thing is that within 6 races, I am thinking... I don't know that we'll be getting first because the test track will not arrive until between races 3 and 4. We're certainly not going to be getting first in the first 4 places unless we get lucky. That is always a possibility in this game. You can always get lucky. In motor racing, there's always a chance of that. Ishikawa, a million up front and 1.2 for 5 races. See, the thing is, I think we might be able to hit that transantarctic bonus before the end of the race. If we hit it twice, no, I think that might be overly optimistic. That might be overly optimistic. I'd rather have a million in the hand, but if we do go for that, we're going to have to go for 1.2 million. Within 4 races, we are not going to be in first within 4 races. We're not going to have the engine to do it. We're not going to have the gearbox to do it. Well, we might have the gearbox to do it. I'm not sure. Yeah, okay, Ishikawa, because I can use that million up front. Accept that offer. Confirm. All right, so that leaves the question of the tail end Charlie. Now, what's the Vamoose offer that's got 1 race to run, 3rd or above? Can we podium in the next race? Probably not. Let's face it, the first Black Sea race is a crapshoot. It's pure luck. It depends on whether your engine blows up or not. Every team is in the same boat because you're not going to have time to get your parts up to a decent level. So it's just going to come down to plain dumb luck. And I'm not going to throw the dice on a 1.5 million bet. So... we'd be looking at these ones for the first races. 7th or above, I think we can do. Yes, seventh or above, we can definitely do. Golden Tiger, I used to love back when we were little Mr. No Marketability. That was a really great, sweet deal. $900,000 up front. Oh, the good old days of 2016. How I fondly remember them, but I'd rather have $450,000 up front and $600,000. Ah, first three races. Guildford is not in the first three races. Oh, that would have been so sweet. See, that's the other thing, too. Should I reject this one and go for, say, Nippon, and then try and pick this one up again come later in the season? Because the Nippon one will only last for four races. Fourth is Tondela. Fifth is, Ardennes. And then I think the one after that is Guildford. And if that was the case, we might be able to pick up the bonus. No, I'm going to take it now. $450,000 up front, $600,000, which I think we're almost guaranteed to get. And yes, that's what I'll take. Would have been tempting, though. We went into Guildford with that, 2.2 times $600,000. Okay, don't second-guess yourself. Never second-guess yourself. Sylvia, you have some empty slots. Let me just pause this and let me fill them. Okay, pause that because watching me select select scouting targets is not the most riveting entertainment around. Basically, I found a couple of new drivers in the 16 to 22 age bracket unemployed, so I got to scout those. And I also want to take a look at Scuderia Rossini, mostly out of curiosity and because we don't have anything else to scout. So that's what Sylvia will be occupied with for the moment. Looks like we have scouted everybody in ERS, so we don't have to worry about that, because obviously I want to make sure that I know. Oh, hang on, there's a new one. Ozu. Okay. Oh, in progress. Nope, we're scouting them. Okay, so I want to make sure that we know about every driver that we're possibly competing against. What's coming up? Improvability gains, that's what we've already looked at. Let's go. Okay, we've got a whole bunch of things that went through there, but I have no idea why we've only got four why I've only got four emails. Let's just go back a bit. Oh, these ones. Yeah, contract ending with what? Maria, Enrique, Darcy. Who are these people? I have no idea. All right, let's go. Scouting report finished. Jonas Brownlish is a fairly decent driver within the ERS. I'll check him out later. Mami Watanuki makes the move to Ozu. Can't wait to get out there on the track. They seem like a great bunch. So the musical chairs continue. Hello, what's this? Andre Gomes caught speeding? Why can't he do that on the track? Was going 112 miles per hour in a 70 miles per hour zone. With all due respect, Your Honor, I'm able to control my car at high speeds. Well, except for that first race in 2016 when you ploughed it into the wall, protested the 24-year-old when he was dragged before the magistrates earlier today. The judge, needless to say, disagreed. It's an embarrassing moment for Gomez's team, Scuderia Quantistica. It's Gomes. What else would you expect? Who are attempting to cultivate a squeaky, clean corporate image. Are you kidding? We're the closest thing in motor racing to the Adams family. Caught speeding. What does that do to him? Marketability plus five. Now he gets plus five marketability after I've signed two sets of contracts. Oh, Lord. Okay, Dieter Wexler. The amazing beard. Oh, my God. Look at those stats. It's 938,000. That's actually only a couple of hundred thousand more than Falco. 100% marketability. Lightning reactions. How old is he? 30. Ah, oh, damn it. By the time we get anywhere near him. Oh, okay. His marketability is plus 40 because of that. Okay. Chairman's happiness. Blah, 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 blah. Rival with driver. Nina Holtz. Good at feedback. Lightning reactions. Yeah. It would be good to have the amazing beard on our team, but no, not going to happen. Okay. What else we got? Nothing else. What's coming up? More scouting. And some mail. Scouting report finished. Daniela Di Meo. Okay, one of the weakest drivers. She has a decent amount of potential. Was she one of the new unemployed ones? 18, yeah, she was one of the new... Wow, look at those stars. Wow, look at that overtaking. Consistency is wonderful, but everything else absolutely blows. A 97% marketability! Oh, come on, what are you doing to me? Feeling blue, that'll pass. 6 weeks. As a reserve driver, no, she's only got 6 feedback. Take her in. No, I don't think there's any... I don't think there's any advantage to be gained there. I'll keep her under advisement anyway. But anyway, clear the scouting flag. Continue. All right, first of February. My January went by fast, didn't it? Scouting report finished. Wolfgang Schmidt, one of the ERS's top drivers, or would be. Risato Corsa. Which? Oh, WMC. Right. Ugly. Oh, good. Minus 30 marketability. Great stuff, but he's got pretty nice stats in every other respect. Not somebody that we're going to have to have a lot to do with. Natasha Masucato. Fun runner. 2 hollow stars. Team Nordhagen? What? Why would I have scouted someone with Team Nordhagen? I have no idea. Unless she was just... she's only started with them this year. She must have been one of the unemployed ones. 39%, not so great. Plus 10 on that from the marketability side. Yeah, cornering is... No, it's irrelevant. She won't speak to us now anyway because nobody in GTCS will speak to anybody in ERS. What's coming up? A unique opportunity. I have a bad feeling. Hacha BMR have been in the news lately after one of their engines caught fire in the garage. We have an opportunity with our upcoming marketing materials. Team marketability plus 25. Chairman's happiness minus 20. Now, the thing about that is that the team marketability is already at 100%. So, it gains us nothing. It loses us chairman's happiness. And I have to worry about that a little bit more this time around, simply because we're probably going to have a higher target, as I've mentioned in previous episodes, and so I'm going to have to just be aware of that, and if we don't hit that target the first few races, obviously that is going to diminish his happiness, but geez, I'd like to have stuck it to Archer BMR. Oh, that would have been so choice. What's coming up? Nothing much. Car improvability, another dilemma. Okay, me and Federico, a few of the engineers and I are worried about the car's improvability over the course of the season. Are you kidding? Do you know how much improvability I gave you when I designed the chassis? We've had a few preliminary talks with the engine supplier and they think they could help us out for a price, of course. Improvability plus one for 1.5 million. So that'd be an extra 6 stars per... 1.5 million. 1.5 million. And again, if this had been... If I'd had this offer at the start of last year, I would have grabbed it with both hands. But the thing is, we're going to have to build probably at least 5 engines and at least 5 gearboxes. And that's going to be a heck of a lot of money. Yeah, last year I would have gone for this because we had to build fewer parts and therefore the cost of the parts would have been less. But again, yeah, I think we're better off concentrating on our strengths in building base parts. Livery edit, one of the most boring parts of the game, I must admit. Scouting report finished. Frieda Fischer, one of the very best drivers. She's unemployed. Whoa, my! Hello! Oh, she's from WMC. She livery edits. Okay, let's go. All right, so we're going to go with... Obviously, we're not changing our colours. The livery pack generally has better ones. Not that, though. Not that. Maybe that. Possibly that. It's the colour of Jupiter. Not the planet, the god. Yeah, don't mind that. Bit pedestrian. No! Yeah. All right. I think that's probably the one that we had this year as well, isn't it? I mean, I don't change my taste. No! Okay, that's not bad. Yeah. No, I am not having a skull painted on the side of my car. It's gonna be either that one or that one. It's gonna be that one. All right, continue. Yes, I'm done editing the car livery. All right, so clear the scouting flag. Actually, let's just get back to the car for a sec there. 83% complete. Fourth of the third is when it is complete. Let's go. We stop for the 1st of March. Pre-season testing this weekend. Are we taking the 2018 car out to pre-season testing? This marks the end of the design phase. All right, go do it, Freddy. Pre-season testing beginning. Well, XBC, you're really on top of the news of the day, aren't you? Pre-season testing is about to begin. Get on with it, Diego. Start the testing. Okay. Sara doesn't have any issues yet, as far as I can see. Gomez doesn't have any issues, but he's not doing well. He's right at the back of the pack. Struggling with understeer. That can't be a good thing. Alright, so Sara's morale didn't crash at all. Gomez has dropped by 16, so he had problems with understeer and he ended up coming at the back of the pack. So Sara's up on fifth. We need Gomez to be in a better position than that if we're going to achieve our position, which, as you know, is fourth. Well, you don't know yet because I haven't agreed to it, but I'm going to agree to fourth. Okay, three items in the mail. Silver Racing lead the way in pre-season season testing, which is irrelevant. Testing went brilliantly this week. Gomez coming 20th is your idea of brilliant, Freddy. I'm happy to report that we're in a strong position for the rest of the season. Gomez was in 20th. Yes, Freddy, that's a strong position. Sara Thomas finished 5th. Our designers and mechanics are now ready to get cracking. All right. Targets for the 2018 season. Here we go. This is where the moment of truth is. Yes, as I knew it would be, our medium position is 4th. So, do I say we can do 2nd? Or do I say we can do 4th? Because if we say we can do 2nd, the problem's going to be in the early races. We might come sufficiently far behind that I might end up getting myself sacked. That is the problem. On the other hand, there's an extra $2 million in it, give or take. No, actually, it's closer to $3 million. Because that's 16.54 versus 19.85. Oh, 3 million. No, fourth. Fourth is what we are going to go for. It is a reasonable balance. And I think we can achieve it. So we're going to go for fourth. 16.54 million up front. Confirm. Right. And now we have the calendar, and it's 11 days until the Black Sea GP. Okay, so that's where we're going to leave matters for the time being, and that will allow us to next week get back into the usual cycle of doing the lead up to the race in the Saturday edition, and then doing the race itself in the Sunday edition. This year I might look at splitting out practice and the race into two separate episodes, but that's TBA. It's actually something that I've been thinking about that I'll need to do once we start doing qualifying as well, because that'll make for too long an episode. As usual, if you enjoyed this episode, it would be greatly appreciated if you would whack the like button over the head, subscribe if you'd like to do so, comment if you'd like to do so. I have a meeting with my senior staff downstairs, so I'm going to say, have a great Sunday. This will be going out on Sunday, and until next time, goodbye. Ragazzi, basta! Just listen to the plan. Fede, let's start with you. This is our first best shot at winning because we will have both a test track and a telemetry center this year, which covers the big two parts, the engine and the gearbox, As of now, we are the only team that will have that, and that gives us great components in both of those parts. Though the test track will not arrive until, let me check my notes here, it's going to be the 22nd of May 2018, so it's just before Tondela. Okay, now what I'm going to need is a minimum of four engines. I am going to need, one with an average component, one with a good component, and two, at least two with great components. Now that may be five, because if we're going to win, we're going to need both cars to be competitive. In engine three, we're only going to be able to use three components, but in engine four, we'll have four. Ideally, I'd like to have a fifth engine, which also has four, so that both cars can make use of the same basic standard. Now, since our policy is to stay risk-free, we may need a more powerful, risky carryover engine as well, though if we win and accept promotion, that would be a wasted effort because engines are a spec in the APS as of now, and I don't think that's likely to change this season. Now, I'll need the same number of gearboxes from you. We can't get any new parts in time for Black Sea 1, but I want two gearboxes up to good standard by Race 2 in Munich, which is an acceleration track. I want two engines ready for Milano, which is also a high-speed track. Gary, I'll have Fede build those with reliability components so that you can get them into race condition as fast as possible. Get them into 75% and I'll be happy. Gary, find me $15 million to build it and you can have one. Fede, I also want two good brakes and two good suspensions, which again, we may need one more to carry over. Total cost, excluding carryover components, will be 20.65 million euros, most of which needs to be funded from sponsor money. So we got 23.5 million in sponsorship money last year, and I'm hoping that we'll get no less this year, though we did last year picked the ripest of the crop, like the Sep Oil deal, which was 6 million up front, which we won't get again this year. On the other hand, we may be able to hit higher sponsor bonuses later in the season if we get ourselves on the podium more often, so it swings and roundabouts. The total projected time for you to do this is 232.4 days, but that is understated because we know that some components will require additional time. We have, let me just check what it is, here we go, 270 days between the start of the competition and the last race. So you have got 232.4 days of work to do. That gives us only 37.6 excess days. That is not a lot, especially considering that you're not going to get that much. So I want you to call your wife and tell her that you won't be back until November. Enough! Verdi opinions. I know, in 2016 I thought, what's the point of saving a third of a day because we'd only build six parts anyway, but in 2018, when we're building 16 parts, the point is almost 5 days. So the design center, level 2 design center, is next year's project. Now, leaving aside the carryover parts, we have about 2.5 million in reserve. A level 2 scouting center costs about 5 million, so it may be possible, Sylvia, but I'm not making any promises. Because a level 2 scouting facility has a swimming pool and a jacuzzi in it? That's the general layout of the plan. The specifics will be adjusted depending on how quickly both the factory and the design center can churn out the new parts and get them into a usable condition. I want us out there with great engines and great gearboxes by race 5. Actually, I don't think that's physically possible. Let's say race 6. We came first in the last race of 2017 by coming third and fifth. We don't need to be on top of the podium each race. We don't need to be the guys who win every race. We just need to be more consistent than the other guys. Questions? That's a very good question. A very, very good question, and not one that I can answer yet. We have to win the thing first. Anyone else? All right, everybody get back to work and remember these words. We will be proud, happy, and thrilled to come forth. Let's go do this.